something you need. Amen. You know, but in all things, you got to have faith. In Amen. All things, Amen. You got to pray.
Amen.
You know, you can't just, you know, decide things are going good. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
You know, as soon as that storm comes, you fall. Amen. You fall out. You just can't do it. You know, and the thing of it is, we got to stop moving on our own power.
Yes.
We got to understand that the power that you have comes from God. So what you do is, you don't stand on your own power. You ask God for His power.
Amen.
And so He's working through you.
Amen. Amen.
You're not working on your own accord.
Yes.
And once we get that and get just like getting in, God saying, you know, I can't let you do this so big, because when you do it big like that, you think it's you. And I won't give him glory for it. So we got to make sure that we always give God His glory.
Amen.
Always. Always. And let God know that you believe.
Yes.
Let Him know you believe.
Yes.
God, I'm standing here. And I'm standing here alone. Lord, I need your power.
Yes.
Lord, I can't do this by myself.
Yes.
Lord, but I know with your help can't nobody prevail against me.
Yes.
Lord, I know this.
Yes.
And then you get up and you shake it off and you walk on. People tell me, well, you just act like you're proud. I ain't proud. I'm a Christian, and I love God.
Amen.
And I believe God. So I don't talk in my head, man. You know, ego up in here, but I know what God done for me.
Yeah.
I know where He done brought me from.
Yeah.
I know the struggles that I done dealt with.
Yeah.
You know, I know these things.
Amen.
And I know I ain't dealing with it now.
Amen.
And He had nothing to do with me.
Yeah.
So yeah. Because I can tell you what God gave to me and what He's done for me. I am a living, walking, breathing testimony that God can.
Amen.
He can. Because you know, there are times in my life, well, I don't believe I should have got back to the house.
Amen.
But I did. There are times when I went out as a young woman, didn't know how I got back to the house.
Amen.
But when I woke up, I was there.
Amen.
I didn't understand it then, but I understand it now.
Amen.
You know, somebody was praying for me.
All Judah and all ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, and thou King Jehoshaphat,
even the king, listen to the Spirit of the Lord. Thus saith the Lord unto you, be not afraid, nor dismayed, by reason of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but God's. Mm-hmm. See, they had come up upon this great multitude once again, mm-hmm. once again, and Jehoshaphat earlier in the chapter had went to God and was like, what to do? But see, instead of him going to his best friend, to his girlfriend, to his wife, to whomever he confided in, he went straight to God and said, what are we going to do? And God turned right around and said to his mind, the Spirit of the Lord said, listen to me. You don't have to be alert. Don't be discouraged. Stand right there and watch me.
Amen.
And that's what we got to do. Things come, because lots of stuff, oh my God. Things will come and you go, you know, and my husband has this thing I always tell him, like, well, you know, so and so and so and so. I got a ticket last week, 2 weeks ago, and all this business, and you know, and then some old bill I had came and I know I ain't got no money for it, whatever. What he tell me? We always been alright, and we're gonna continue to be alright.
Amen.
And that's it. That's where your mind has to go.
Amen.
That's what you got to tell yourself. God has always provided. And he will continue to provide.
Amen.
And you got to believe that. You can't worry yourself to death wondering if he will provide. Because he always does. You know, and I look at my sisters and brothers that are much older than me, you know, 70, 80s, you know, people I live with, because we live in a retirement community, much older people. I can't even imagine the stuff that God has brought them through to get them to where they at right now. And I reverence that because I know God has done so many things, and the stuff that they've seen in 80 years, I can't even imagine, because I think about the stuff that I've seen in 50 years in Jesus Christ. I can't imagine. And I thank God for them, because that also brings remembrance to my mind. You know, if I want to get to 80, if it's God's will, I got to go through some more stuff. You know, and I've got to be faithful with that stuff. I just thank God that, you know, he gave me the enlightenment to understand that I got to lean on him.
Amen.
That I can't lean on my husband only. That I can't lean on my friends only. You know, even my mom and my dad, they didn't have all the answers. You know, and my grandma used to say, you better take that to God. Didn't understand what that meant.
Amen.
But she used to always say, you better take that to God.
Amen.
You're like, oh. Okay, you know, because you don't understand what that means. But then when you do get an understanding of what it means, and you're able to take it to God, you know, and you're able to leave it there with him. Because see, you know when you leave it with God, because when you get up off your knees, you're not worried about it no more.
Amen.
You know, somebody will come up to you and say, well, what you gonna do? Oh, that's take care of it. I got that. I ain't worried about it. I'm going on to the next thing, because there's always a next thing.
Amen.
If you give it to God, leave it with God,
Amen.
And go on to the next thing.
Amen.
Because if you ask him, like Asa did, like Jehoshaphat did, like Gideon did, oh Lord, what now?
Yeah.
Leave it right there.
Yeah.
Let God fight the battle for you.
Yeah.
Because see, God knows that if you are a Christian, the devil is going to rage up against you.
Yeah.
And there are going to be things, just like the Job, that he's going to try to take from you. You know, or that he will take from you.
Amen.
You know, but you still got to be steadfast and say, the Lord giveth and the Lord takes it away. God allows all these things to happen. What we got to understand and have faith in is that everything that happens is for our good.
Amen.
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 There's some good in it. And just like I said, find some good in that. I'm going to find some good in that. Because everything that the devil don't have no power.
Amen.
Except for what God. And you got to try to understand why. Why did he take this away from me? You know, what am I not doing?
Amen.
Or what am I doing that he took this away from me?
Yeah.
God is not even going to allow Satan to message you unless he gives him authority to do so.
Amen.
So we got to thank God for all of that.
Amen.
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 And I'm going to leave you with saying, stand still. Be firm in your belief. And don't let nobody rock you.
Amen.
By saying what they say.
Amen.
You know, driving a big car, living in a big house.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because when God gives you There ain't nothing that you can buy that can equal that value.
Amen.
Because you're not worried. You're not struggling. And in the midst of controversy, you got a huge smile on your face, Amen. And you singing your song, Trouble in My Way, and you jumping up and down, and don't nobody understand why, because this thing just happened to you. I know she can't be that happy. Oh, yeah!
Amen.
I am that happy.
Amen.
I am that happy. Because you know why? If God took that from me, evidently I didn't need it. Because why? I went on to the next time.
Amen.
On to the next time.
Amen.
And it's okay.
Amen.
You know, I say, oh, she don't have no food in your refrigerator. Yeah, I do have food in my refrigerator. The stuff I eat. I got water,
Amen.
I got eggs, I got blood, Jesus, and bread. What? You don't know where I'm from. You don't know the struggle that I've been through. I can make a 5-course meal with just old women and things. And don't let people get the cup and see no fire. Oh, it's on me. Because if God can show me what a struggle is.
Amen.
So don't nothing make me struggle.
Amen.
Not no more. I don't struggle anymore. Because you know the 5 things that I do got, will make that work.
Amen.
I ain't never lost a pound, and I ain't always had a refrigerator for food.
Amen.
So I know God works out.
Amen.
Like that.
Amen.
You know, and I can cook a bean 27 ways. I mean,
Amen.
You know, we gonna eat. We gonna eat. Whether we got $500 or $5.